Welcome to the Las Vegas Strip. Today I'm going to take you on a tour of the cultural landscape here, and we'll stop in two of the major hotels. I'll also discuss a bit about some of the other areas near here. Las Vegas, especially the Strip, is largely filled with tourists. There are lots of people living in the Vegas area, but most are workers at places in the Strip. While there are a few large residential districts like you might see around here, they are pretty far off the Strip. The Strip itself was mostly just for tourists, hence the reason why almost every building along it is a hotel. The hotels themselves feature very elaborate theming, mostly to different worldwide locations. I'll get into the hotels later, but they are all very different from each other. Vegas is notorious for its gambling, and every hotel on the Strip features a large casino. Even the airport has slot machines. This goes to further show that Las Vegas is a large tourist destination. In terms of transportation, the main form is through taxis. There's also a lot of walking, but something that's interesting is that they don't let you cross the streets. Instead, there are bridges over every street with escalators leading up to them. This allows for traffic to move more efficiently, and people under the influence don't end up getting hit by cars. There are also some trams and shuttles, but they only go to specific places. If you enter the Paris Hotel and Casino, you can already see some of the theming to the real Paris. The sign for the casino entrance is in French, as are the signs for the bathrooms. This hotel stands out, as they have a half-size Eiffel Tower replica that you can actually go up in. The casino itself is also made to look like Paris, and a support of the Eiffel Tower is even located in the middle of the casino. It's made to seem as if you are outside, as there are clouds painted on the ceiling, fake streetlights, and typical awnings. This just goes to show the theming is even in the casino. The shopping district area is also made to look like Paris, with many traditional French restaurants and bakeries, including a wonderful crepe shop. Most of the signs are also written in French, and they do a great job simulating the real Paris,
especially through traditional French architecture.
Moving on to the New York Hotel, you can see the theming as we are outside of the hotel. You can see the imitation Brooklyn Bridge. The casino, like Paris, features elaborate theming that makes you feel like you're in the streets of New York. The restaurants are very typical restaurants you would see in New York, such as pizza places, hot dog stands, and delis. The hotel even features a sit-down looping hypercoaster built by Togo. The station is in the hotel, but most of the actual coaster is outside. This showcases Coney Island and its importance on New York culture. Our final destination is Tahiti Village, a resort located about 10 minutes off the Strip. This hotel is more for families, as there are no casinos and it features a large pool, lazy river, and 3 hot tubs. It may be off the Strip and meant for a different audience, but it still has great theming. It is themed to a tropical setting, as showcased by the pool areas and the architecture of the building. As you can see here, we have 2 different types of palm trees in our nicely themed Tropic Tahiti Village Resort. Entrance of Tower 5, and as you can see, it's a canopy and even has moss on the top and is surrounded by lovely palm trees. The building itself has some quite intricate theming. We enter Tower 5, you can immediately smell the coconut radiating out of the vents. This is a very nice ambiance that adds to the overall tropical theming. You can see the carpets and plants that add to the overall tropical atmosphere. Overall, Las Vegas is a very diverse city with many unique people and buildings. It is largely a tourist destination, as seen by themed hotels. The residential areas are all at least 15 minutes off the Strip, and almost every house features an outdoor pool as an accommodation to the climate. The cultural landscape in Vegas is very different from the cultural landscape of Chicago. It was very fun and interesting to explore Vegas and see just how different it is from the city of Chicago. Although I didn't get much into the surrounding areas, you can still see some differences in cultural landscape. I hope this taught you a bit about this area, and stay tuned for more cultural landscape videos. Lego.
shut up with perfect timing. Now here we are.